Hi everyone, and to us Canadians, happy May 24, or as other folk might call it, Victoria Day weekend. I'm finally going to put up that damn shed of mine. I have nothing but scrap pieces of wood here and there, so I built a floor frame. Ooh, how straight it is. But the most important part is it's true. Everything else inside is all wonky, but I don't do this kind of thing normally, so put the best I could do. I got it all leveled up, and I figured that's the best spot for it, right beside my shop. And my floor is over here. It's all 3/4 inch plywood, but it's even bits and pieces. I had like crappy wood and I cut out all the good parts and made a floor. I still got to cut it to size, but it covers the general area. I had to do a little modification here because that's that corner piece of floor. So put all that together soon, and I figured when I actually put the shed up, I wanted to do it today, but I screwed up and cut twice and measured once. So I had to, I went by Buddy's framework, and his was like 10 feet 3 inches. The shed's 10 feet. So I went by his original framing because none of those crossbars would have fit if I would have done it the way I wanted it to. So I cut it all together and then I realized, hey, wait a minute, what the hell? So I had to take all this apart and then I cut 3 inches off of that so that that would compensate and make 10 feet even. So now we got 10 feet. And I looked back in my video when I picked this up again, and I had a nightmare that maybe this was all screwed. But in the video, his width from here to here was good. Because man, if I would have had to change that too, I would have had to take everything apart. Like, it wasn't as elaborate as it was now. It was only this, this, and this, and this. But yeah, that would have been a pain. So at least all I had to do is take that off, cut 3 inches off, scoot it all over, and then re-level it. But yeah, so that's for that little piece of floorboard. I figured I'd make something solid for it to land on. And the other one comes over that completely. So that should be more than fine. Yeah, so I figured when I put it together, I wanted to get it together this weekend, but it looks like it's going to be pretty windy tomorrow. And you shouldn't be putting these things up in the wind. I'll see how it is, because I'd like to get this floor. It's Sunday now, and tomorrow's the holiday. So I'd like to be able to have that floor laid and get this thing up. And when I put it up, I'll just do like a time lapse from back yonder and just show us running around like little freaks. And then poof, there's a shed. Yeah, I know. Talk about overkill, eh? Well, framing's never been something that I've really ever done. And I did this all by hand. I had no square. I was using like pieces of wood to be my square and draw lines. And I was just measuring and cutting as I go. And when I had it together initially, I saw soft spots, because that was it, bare, and that was bare, and that was bare. Like, I only had the center coming through, figuring everything would be strong enough. But I saw soft spots here and there for the long ones, like the long space. So I just figured out the hell with it. I found a couple more 6x6s and I used as many of that as I could, and then substituted with a bunch of 2x4s. But I figured out, that floor is going to be strong enough. Probably a waste of wood. And as I say, they might not be straight, but that floor is solid as a rock. One thing I didn't think about, and the hell with it, I'm not moving it now. These stupid walnut trees. That shed is going to get the shit kicked out of it with those walnuts. Bang, ba bang, 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 ba bang, bang, bang. Bang. I literally have to put a hard helmet on in the fall, like a construction helmet, to cut the lawn, because these things fall down, and when they hit you in the head, they leave an egg. Like with the husk and everything, oh, they're heavy. Boom! Ah! There you go. My half-ass floor. Solid as a rock. Looks like a piece of shit. But that's okay. Pieces and bits. Did have one little screw up here. Had a bow in the wood. So I was trying to cut along it. I dug in and hit a freaking screw. Aye, aye, aye. Bucked back on me. So I just left a bit of a, more of a lip here. But, what the hell, that's only the back corner there. It's all within tolerance, as far as I'm concerned, for free shed. And, with all those studs everywhere, I only missed one. I'll take that out later and fill the hole up. Not bad, considering it was a spider web of uneven studs. Well, if tomorrow is going to be a reasonable day without wind, then this bugger's going up. Ciao for now.